Stay tuned for Pineapple Johnson, Cowboy Junkies, Joan Burton, and more. It's time for Nickel City Scene. Jackie Thurn, welcome to your music show, Nickel City Scene. Thanks to everyone for all the letters and email. Michelle from Canisius College liked our Edge Fest show, but she was disappointed that we didn't interview the 10,000 Maniacs. Sorry, Michelle, but the Maniacs said no to our offer, but they did promise us an interview when they released their new CD. The new band features Mary Ramsey on vocals. Look for the CD early next year. Tonight you're going to hear music from all over our region. We're going to meet Buffalo's Pineapple Johnson and Toronto's Cowboy Junkies. We'll show you a music video from Rochester's Joan Burton, and we'll check in at 103.3 The Edge. Pineapple Johnson is a straightforward, hardworking, dedicated Buffalo band. I'm here in their studio to talk about their CD Punchdrunk and about their musical philosophies. Tell me how the band got together.
Back in December of, was it 1992 or 1993, Charlie? 1992. I met Joe. We got together, we started writing some tunes. We went through, like, the Spinal Tap roster of drummers. A few spontaneously combusted. We hooked up with Scott Slomba, then we hooked up with Stinky here, Jeff Kaloje. We pieced together a bunch of tunes. We started playing out a lot, trying to build a name. And then Rob Guido joined the band a year and a half ago.
How did the style of your music change after Rob joined the band?
I think it opened us up a lot because Rob is a blues player. And we were, you know, pretty much on punk rhythms and heavier stuff. And we still have those same rhythms, which is really good as a bass structure for our tunes. But I think where Rob just, you know, gave us another dimension we didn't have.
So tell me, when was your CD Punchdrunk released?
Punchdrunk was released in September or August of around that time, like last year. So it's been on about a year.
We did some of the discs, most of the music at Audio Magic, and then they moved us to Select Sound because they're having problems, and we mixed it. It was mixed there. We still have a lot to learn about. You know, I mean, it's second time we've been in the studio. First time was, you know, a learning experience. Thought the second time we'd have it down, but it's like you see, I mean, you're always learning stuff, so it's always a learning experience.
How much did it cost to the whole process of putting a CD together?
Actually, it cost us a lot less than it might have. For the amount we spent, the artwork that we have on that CD, that was photographed by my father. Really, it was. And he's not a professional photographer or anything, but he did an awesome job on the lighting and everything. And the guy on the cover is my cousin.
Nice.
So you can do these kind of things, you know. Most people out there could, the CD we did, there's almost any band that if you're playing regular gigs, you could afford.
How are sales going?
for the CD. They're going pretty well.
What else you selling, Joe?
See the light, hear the music of your prime mover. See the light, hear the music of your prime mover.
What's in the future for the band? Any future plans?
I think, you know, we did this CD and it was really good. I think it was above our expectations. And I think it's healthy for us to let that soak in. If we had started writing immediately, I think our stuff would have come out just sounding like the CD. I think now we haven't really written, we've been playing it, and I think that we've reached a point where we're sick of it. And it's time for us to grow, and it's time for us to start writing again. And I think that you'll see it's a new direction.
Maybe we'll write a love song.
Never.
Yeah, because we definitely don't write love songs.
No. See the light, hear the music of your prime mover.
You can buy Pineapple Johnson's CD Punchdrunk at all area record stores. The band is also submitting a song for the TV themes album from 103.3 The Edge. If they make it, you'll hear Pineapple Johnson perform the theme song from Cheers. When we come back, this popular songwriter is getting lots of radio play in Rochester. Her strong voice has been compared to Ann Wilson of Heart. We have her first music video. Joan Burton is next on the scene.
A sea of people that's so repressed.
Welcome back. Joan Burton has been studying music all her life. She moved to Rochester in 1984 after attending the Berklee School of Music. Joan played keyboards and sang backup for several bands before deciding to start her own band. Only a Moment Away is Joan's first album. The song you're going to hear is about the tragedy shown on TV news every day. It was inspired by the 1989 uprising in China at Tiananmen Square. Here's Joan Burton with Time Can't Stop the Pain.
To be free.
Moment Away is available wherever local music is sold. Her song, New World, is also featured in the movie Twilight of the Dogs. Joan is currently recording a new album, Flames of Fame. It's being produced by Lou Graham from Foreigner and is due out in early 97. We have to take a short break, but when we come back, we're heading out to the Funhouse with Rod Ryan. Over the Edge is next on the scene.
It's Rod Ryan live at the Funhouse, and as you're gonna see, this is what I have done every Tuesday night for the last year. You're in for a ride.
When I wake up in the morning, I still wish that you were there. All I have to do is think about you, and I hope you care. Knowing full well that the two of us have lasted for so long.
Very proud.
All right, continuing our Tuesday night here at the Funhouse, you just never know who you're going to find. Robby Takac, Robby Goo, hanging out at the arcade over here, and he's having some trouble. He can't. I thought you were going
to
play here.
Well, we were trying to get this to work solely to prove one point. You know what that point is?
No, but I'm dying to know.
That you don't drink test tubes full of Jägermeister.
Hi, Mom. Robby, what are you doing in town, man? It's great to see you, as always, but what are you doing here in town? I know you guys have such a hectic schedule. Where are you guys headed after this? I mean, you must have probably not very much time off.
I have today off. We're playing in St. Pete, actually, Minnesota tomorrow. And my mom lives about a block from here. And she'd be so happy to know that you and I are sitting here drinking test tubes full of the Jägermeister.
She'll be happy to know that I'm crashing on her couch tonight.
That's all right. That's fine.
So let's talk about the show coming up, the 28th at the Marine Midland Arena. It's got to be exciting for you, the first rock concert at the new arena. I mean, what are you and the guys talking about?
Well, first we're talking about how the Philharmonic is totally going to rock the place the night before we play there.
Absolutely, yeah. Nani DeFranco coming in for a couple of tunes.
You know what I'm saying, right? So we actually are the second rock show.
Okay. The second rock show, Marine Midland Arena. What are you guys thinking? It's sold out in like 2.5 hours. That's got to make you feel good.
Yeah, but it's not 9 minutes. And Kip Missile, over and over again, every time I turn on the damn radio, Pearl Jam sold out in 9 minutes.
All right, I'm going to be on tomorrow saying 2.5 hours, 2.5 hours. Yeah, but
No. Now on you live. 2.5 minutes. 2.5 minutes.
Yeah,
Buffalo is so great to us, man. I'm just really happy about the whole thing, really. Everybody's been really cool. You've been so cool. The Edge, Rich, everybody's been so...
I've been cool.
You know how cool you've been? Come on, baby. Hop in my car. Let's Uh-oh. Take a ride.
Oh, no.
Here we go.
I'm going for a ride. Woohoo!
Hey, listen, this is Rod Ryan and Robby from the Goo Goo Dolls. We're taking a ride. We'll see you later.
Look for 103.3 The Edge every Tuesday night at the Funhouse. But don't look for Rod Ryan. He's starting a new job and leaves The Edge this week. Good luck, Rod. Coming up, this Toronto band has been together for 10 years. They played in town last week, and I caught up with Margo Timmins for an interview. Stick around for the Cowboy Junkies, next on Nickel City Scene. If you like what I'm wearing, you can buy it at Bonwit Teller. Check out Nickel City Scene online. Visit our website at www.acadia.com. Our email box is open. The Cowboy Junkies have 5 critically acclaimed CDs that sold over 3 million copies. Their 6th CD, Lay It Down, is out on Geffen Records, including the hit single, Common Disaster. The Cowboy Junkies played here at UB Center for the Arts. I spoke with vocalist Margo Timmins before the show.
Just when I thought that I discovered the secret to peace and tranquility, that lonely sinking feeling creeps up on me.
You've recorded 6 CDs. Tell me how they've all differed, the past from this one, Lay It Down.
I think Lay It Down, the biggest difference from the last 5 is probably, at least from the last 3, Michael on this album has taken up the lead guitar role, which he did on the first 2. So that's making it different. Also, it's a lot sparser.
What inspired the lyrics on Lay It Down?
Well, Michael's the writer. And I think he gets inspired by all kinds of things. I think books, definitely. He reads a lot. Life, meeting people on the road especially, and hearing their stories.
So he writes the lyrics, but then you give them life. How do you make them your own?
Well, I think there's 2 things. Firstly, I think as a singer, I'm a storyteller. I mean, that's my job, is to give the song meaning or make it believable. So you just do that by expressing how you feel, what you think the song is about. And secondly, I think Michael as a songwriter is totally egoless. When he gives me a song, he truly gives me the song. He doesn't tell me how he wants it done or tell me what he meant by it. So he truly allows me to take it and to interpret it in my own way.
Singing comes straight from the heart. It's so emotional. Is it hard to get it to where you want it? Did you lessons, practice?
Well, in the early days, I didn't take lessons because I felt that my style was, just as you said, was just based on sort of being natural about it and just doing it and not thinking too much about it. And I was afraid that lessons would make me think more on the technical side than the emotional side. After our last album, Pale Sun, Crescent Moon, I began to feel more confident that I could hang on to the natural side of my voice and also learn some technique, which I really needed to learn. So I did take some lessons for this album and will continue to. It's really opened up a lot, and I still feel I've retained what makes my voice different.
Tell me a little bit about the recording and how, what's his name, John Keehan? Mm-hmm. How did he influence your CD?
Well, John's the first producer we've ever used. We've always recorded our own music. We were nervous about it, and he came in and sort of said, listen, what I want to do is capture your music the way that you do it. I don't want to tell you how to do it, and I don't want to change it. And so it allowed us to play our music and feel free that what was going down onto tape was what we wanted.
Is it difficult working together because you're family, or does it bring you closer together?
Well, definitely it brings you closer together, because, you know, here we are, we're all in our 30s, you know, when brothers and sisters are usually living their lives separately with their individual families and only coming together at Christmas or Thanksgiving or something. A lot of the experiences that we have, we're able to really share in the same way because our values are the same and our morals and where we came from. Working closely like you do in a band where you're living together day in and day out, it's going to be hard with anybody because it's very close. But for me, it's easier because they're my brothers. I can tell them how I feel, or I can understand how they feel without even hearing. And I know how to give them space, and I know how to slap them around a bit when they need it, and vice versa. And I think that's what keeps us sort of grounded in this industry, because it's a strange world to work in. And I think they keep everything kind of amusing.
Cowboy Junkies really are a family affair. Michael, Margo, and Peter Timmins grew up in a house filled with music, and bass player Alan Anton is one of Michael's oldest friends. Look for Lay It Down in stores now. I'm afraid we're out of time for this week, but we'll be back next Saturday with more great local music. Keep those letters coming. We're always looking for your story ideas and comments on the show. The address is Nickel City Scene, care of the Media Center, 2001 Main Street, Buffalo, New York, 14208. For Nickel City Scene, I'm Jackie Thurn. Thanks for watching, keep supporting local music, and I'll see you next week.